We take quality control and assurance very seriously, and we've invested a lot in technology and in personnel development to make sure that we do it right. One of the most useful and versatile pieces of quality assurance equipment that we have in our measurement laboratory is our Zeiss Comet L3D Mark II 3D scanner. In this episode of Engineering 101, we want to look at how it works and what makes it so valuable. First of all, for any 3D scanning system to work properly, we must first have a 3D CAD file of the customer's part to use as a reference. From this file, we can derive all critical tolerances and dimensions. Then, after we've made a physical part according to the customer's requirements, we place that part on the calibrated platen of our Zeiss Comet L3D 3 Mark II. It has a strong blue LED light source, coupled with the world-famous precision optics of the Zeiss glass lens. The LED shines a pattern onto the surface of the part that we're measuring, which is then reflected back to the lens. This pattern is recorded in the form of individual pixels, whose position is calculated using triangulation from the light source. This type of system is called fringe projection. Now, how is the data used? The Zeiss Comet is able to record up to 5 million individual data points per second. These points are fed into specialized software, which creates a point cloud, and from this cloud, a complete 3D CAD model of the part can be easily constructed. We typically take the model generated from the Zeiss and compare it to the CAD file supplied by the customer. The model can be rotated until it achieves a best fit with the reference, and from there we can identify any discrepancies. This approach is ideal for plastic injection molded parts. That's because they are often subject to very minor warping, shrinkage, or other distortions that are hard to measure conventionally and which don't perfectly match the ideal three-dimensional program. But first, a message from our sponsor. It's us, Star Rapid. We're a world-class manufacturer and service provider of customized high-precision metal and plastic parts and tooling to support new product development. We offer CNC machining, plastic injection molding, vacuum casting, high-pressure die casting, and finishing services to customers around the world. Contact us to meet the sales representative in your region. Now, back to the video. The Zeiss Comet is very compact, so it can be used even in a busy shop like ours, where we already have a lot of equipment on the floor. The LED works just fine, even if the ambient lighting conditions are less than ideal. And both the LED light source and the lens can be swapped out to account for different focal lengths and different size parts. The Zeiss is coupled with an automatic rotating turntable for 360-degree measurements, and it can be quickly calibrated and operated with minimal training time. Another great feature of the Zeiss Comet is that it lets you take a completed part or complex assembly and then reverse engineer it by deconstructing individual segments using the graphical software interface. That means we can test how a single part will fit into a larger assembly, which might be made of many parts, even if those parts exist in different locations. This makes it much easier to manage today's complex supply chains. There are a few potential limitations, however, and these apply to all optical systems. If a part is completely transparent or highly polished, it needs to be dusted with a fine spray of alcohol-based pigment. This doesn't harm the part, but it helps the LED light to focus on the surface. Also, the scanner might have problems with very small but deeply recessed pockets. Basically, if your cell phone camera has trouble seeing a feature, so will the Zeiss. We hope you found this information useful. And if you want to learn more, please check out Serious Engineering, our ongoing video series where we explore engineering and manufacturing processes in greater detail. We'll leave a link here. Don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon, and we'll see you next time.